Hi, I'm Jane Velez Mitchell, and I am here with Donnie Moss. We are doing nightly breaking news stories about animal rights posted on my Facebook, facebook.com/Jane Velez Mitchell, and also originating on theirturn.net. Donnie Moss is the founder of theirturn.net, and he's an investigative journalist who came up with a horrific story about the transport of millions of sheep and cows and other farm animals from Australia to the Middle East. These animals often left to die, you know, literally languish in their own feces, and disease is rampant. It's a horror show. And Donnie, tell us basically what you've learned and how you've reached out to authorities in Australia.
So just as a recap for people who weren't watching yesterday, we learned yesterday that a major news network in Australia released undercover footage taken by Animals Australia of what happens to the thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, of animals who are shipped alive to countries in the Middle East and Southeast Asia. And the footage was gruesome, but it's something that's going to jolt Australia into taking action against the live transport industry. Since that story aired, your story aired yesterday, I learned that these undercover investigations have in fact curbed live exports to some of the worst abusers, Iran and Indonesia and Gaza. But those suspensions have since been lifted, at least in two of those three countries.
Jeez.
And the goal, obviously, of the animal protection community in Australia is to end all live exports.
Absolutely.
And eventually they will be ended. In the meantime, they need our help. The animals need our help, and the Australian activists need our help.
We're pretty much the only news organization in the United States that's on this right now, but this was broken. This story was broken by a major Australian news organization. And so it's a scandal in Australia, but, you know, Australia relies a lot on tourism dollars. I've been to Australia. It's a beautiful country. I've been to the Barrier Reef and to Sydney and Brisbane. But the point is that we need to let Australia know that this is going to hurt their reputation. I mean, it's barbaric. It's beyond barbaric. It's barbarism, plain and simple, and it has to stop. And I know that you, Donnie, have reached out to the Australian Tourism Bureau. Tell us what you've learned and what your conversations were.
So we posted yesterday on theirturn.net information about what people can do to take action on behalf of these animals. And one of the action items was to contact the Australia Tourist Board here in the United States. And I picked up the phone and I called them myself, and I reached the person I was trying to reach, and she was very nice. And she said she had already received several calls and emails as a result of the story. She reached out to the communications department for the Australia Tourism Board to get more information. She herself wasn't aware of live exports. And she's going to send us details about other people we should be contacting to address this issue. Since then, we've also added a instant message that people can click one button on the website of Animals Australia to reach the U.S., the Australia Embassy in Washington.
That's animals, plural, Australia.org. AnimalsAustralia.org. So we are showing that literally a small group of people, and we're not that small, we're growing. And my Facebook likes are growing every day by the hundreds because people are hungry for this kind of information, because Americans love animals, we're decent people, and when we see something this horrific, we want to take action. So don't say, oh, this is too depressing for me to listen to. Say, wow, I can do something to help these voiceless animals that are suffering so horrifically. I can reach out by going to animals, plural, Australia.org, animalsaustralia.org, and following the links, and you can do an instant message to the Australian Embassy in Washington, D.C. This is huge. You just heard from Donnie the impact that just several calls had. And I believe those several calls were as a result of theirturn.net doing the story, and then
it's
I was posting
o'clock.
It. And and resending it and tweeting it, and we're spreading it over platforms. So take action. And by the way, this is, again, an ongoing nightly conversation that we're going to have Monday through Friday. I'm also covering protests today. I went out and I covered videotape protests against carriage horse industry. I'm going to show that to you in the coming days. So we have something every single night about animal rights, breaking news. This is the social justice movement of the 21st century. So, Donnie, I want to give you the last word. And by the way, I'm sure some of you remember Rico. Rico was fine. He said, am I still doing this? I said, yes, you are, little Rico. You still got to speak up and show your face for the animals. Final word, Donnie.
So one more word on behalf of these cattle and sheep in Australia who are loaded and shipped to the Middle East. The Australian animal protection groups obviously want to see an end to live export. And the practical solution, because cattle and sheep industry in Australia are huge, and what they're proposing is that the slaughter be done locally to save these animals 30 extra days of the most horrific treatment you could ever imagine. Obviously, we'd all like to see people stop consuming cattle or beef and stop wearing sheep. In the meantime, this is a practical solution as all of us work together to encourage people to adopt a cruelty-free lifestyle.
Yes, and it just shows you what goes into meat production. Australia, you need to ban this. You need to ban it now. My understanding from Dominie is that New Zealand has banned it. If you want to be considered a first world country, I mean, this is absolutely de rigueur. It must happen. Ban these exports. We're going to keep getting the message to the people who make these decisions. And that means the Australian Embassy and the Australian Tourism Board. People in Australia are decent, wonderful people. Again, I've visited it, but this has to end. And I'm sure that most people in Australia, when they find out about this hidden horror, you told me, Donnie, sometimes they unload the animals at night because they don't want anybody to see. They don't want people to see what's going on, all for profit. It's really upsetting, but the good news is together we can take action. Thank you, Donnie Moss. Until the next report, tomorrow night, we're going to have another breaking news story right here.
Thanks,
until Jane. Then.